Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing limits right now, and this is a video lecture number 26. So this is part 26. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 25 before watching part 26. So today we are going to discuss some good questions related to limits, which is definitely build up your confidence and concept as well. And let me discuss those questions, which will be very, very helpful for IITJ Advanced and all other competitive examinations as well. It will be also good for developing the fundamental logic and concepts of the various applications of the different types of functions, how to deal with that when we are solving the questions related to limit. So let me discuss first question today. And the first question is question number one. That limit n tends to infinity and limit x tends to 0, 1 upon 1 to the power cot square x plus 2 to the power cot square x plus 3 to the power cot square x till n to the power cot square x whole to the power tan square x. This is for question. And that you have to evaluate what will be the value of that. Maybe some options are given. I can write here. Options are say like 0, then 1, then C is minus 1, and D none of these. So can be like this. Anything can happen, you know, if you have options. So what to do? First of all, to solve this question, let me write some solution of this question. What to write here? First of all, we will take on cot square x is equal to say y. So when x tends to 0, cot 0 is, what is cot 0? Cot 0 is infinity. So y tends to infinity. In that case, what will happen? This limit will be limit n tends to infinity. Limit x tends to 0 will change as limit y tends to 0. And 1 upon, this is 1 to the power y plus 2 to the power y plus 3 to the power y plus n to the power y and whole to the power, because cot x is y, so tan x must be 1 by y. At this point, now limit n tends to infinity, 1 by y tends to 0, limit y tends to 0. If I can take n to the power y common, then what will happen? 1 by 1 to the power y here, n to the power y common, then it will divide all the terms. So that will be 1 by n to the power y, 2 by n to the power y, 3 by n to the power y, and here what will happen? This is has been taken common, so it will remain 1 only. And n to the power y, I have taken common, and whole to the power 1 by y. So in that case, n to the power, whole to the power 1 by y, will remain limit n tends to infinity, limit y tends to 0, n to the power y, full to the power 1 by y, will give n only, n in denominator. And what will be here? That will come 1 by n to the power y, plus 2 by n to the power y, like this, 3 by n to the power y, and plus 1, and whole to the power 1 by y. So if you write this all, what will happen? This is less than 1 because it is increasing sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to n. So n definitely would be much greater than 1, much greater than 2, greater than 3. Means any one of the term, n must be greater than that. So if you divide by n, divide by something greater, then 1 by n will be less than 0, less than 1. And less than 1, less than 1, less than 1, all the terms will be prior to 1, will be less than 1. And anything less than 1, and if you are going to increase the power, then that will be much lesser, 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 and lesser. And when power increases to infinity, then that will tends to 0. So that will be 0, that will be 0, that will be 0, and finally 1. So 1 to the power, and 1 by infinity is 0. So y tends to infinity, this is the infinity. So 1 less than 1 to the power y, that is infinity, is always 0, 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1, that is 1, and 1 to the power 0 is 1. But n tends to infinity, what will happen? 1 by n tends to 0. So in that case, answer will be 0, because it will be 0 into 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus this up to 1 plus 1 whole to the power 0. And this is what? 0 answer. Because 0 into 1. Finally here 1 will left, but 0 into 1 is 0. So answer is 0 of this question. Let me explain once again. This question seems difficult but easy, quite easy. No need to write even this step. Just one line is more than enough to write the answer of this question. If you put cot square x is equal to y, then tan square x must be 1 by y. Right? And when x tends to 0, cot 0 is infinity, and infinity square is also infinity. So when x tends to 0, y tends to infinity. I have written limit n tends to infinity because limits have been changed, function is changed, so limit is also changed. Y tends to 0, 1 to the power y, 2 to the power y, 3 to the power y, what I have written n to the power y, whole to the power 1 by y. If I would have taken n to the power y common, then this will come only. N to the power y, if I would have taken common, n to the power y, whole to the power 1 by y is only 1 by n. And this all terms will be lesser than 1. Y tends to infinity, lesser than 1, and power which going to infinity, that will definitely vanish. It will become 0, 0, 0, and finally 1. So 1 and 1 by y is 0. So 1 to the power 0 is 1. But because of this n tends to infinity, 1 by n tends to 0. 0 multiplied by 1 would be 0. And that will be the answer of this question. Right? So what will be next? Let me try. Next question. Second question. Let us see this second question. Okay. Limit n tends to infinity. Sigma k is equal to 1 to n and k divided by 1 plus k square plus k 4. If this is a question, then how to deal with this question? It is very difficult for the students to understand this, what to do and how to make it. It is some type of partial fraction that you have to split into difference of two functions. Whenever there is such question, you need to split them in difference of two functions. And when you split them as a difference of two functions, your work will be 2g. What to do and how to do that? Let me explain this. I can add k square and subtract k square in this. So it will be 1 tends to infinity, sigma k is equal to 1 to n, and k divided by 1 plus 2k square plus k4 minus k square. Can I write like this? Yes. So what will happen then? I can write it k is equal to 1 to n. This is k upon 1 plus k whole square, or k plus 1 whole square, you know, k square plus 1 whole square, this one, minus k square. So that can be further written as sigma k is equal to 1 to n and k divided by k square plus 1 plus k and k square plus 1 minus k. A square minus B square, A plus B, A minus B. Now this further can be rearranged as sigma k is equal to 1 to n, 1 upon k square plus k plus k square minus k plus 1 minus 1 upon k square plus k plus 1. If you do for partial fraction, you will get it. Otherwise, very simple idea what I have. The called this method is in Hindi kya khoya kya paya, means find the different signs, just put a negative sign between these two factors and then try to think what we got and what we lost. If you do that, the LCM will be same, but in numerator this is k square plus k plus 1, minus k square minus k plus 1. Due to this negative sign, it would be positive sign. So k square plus 1 and k square plus 1 would be vanished. But 1k from this side, another k from this side would be 2k. So why not divide by 2? So that we neither got anything nor lost anything. But what we did, just arrange this. Kya khoya, kya paya? So put the negative sign in between, rearrange them and think what we got, and to manage this, divide by that constant. So I have divided by this constant, because we will get, after doing this, simplifying this, we will get 2k, and 2k divided by 2 will remain k. So in that case, we neither lose something nor gain something, and we can rearrange them. Now if I put n is equal to k is equal to 1, what will happen? If I put k is equal to 1, that will be 1 square minus 1, that is 0, plus 1, that is 1, so 1. And here what will come? 1 square plus 1 plus 1, that is 1 by 3. So when k I will put, this will come 1 minus 1 by 3. If I put k is equal to 2, what will come? 2 square minus 2, that is 2 square is 4, 4 minus 2 is 2, plus 1, 3, 1 by 3. And here it will come 1 by 7. So 1 by 3, 1 by 7. 1 by 3, when k I put 1, then that will be 1 by 3, that is negative. And when k is equal to 2 put, then that 1 by 3 would be positive. So they consecutively, one positive, one negative term will come, and they will vanish each other. So if you put k is equal to 1 to 3, then this will come, limit n tends to infinity, 1 by 2, and this thing will come 1 minus 1 by 3, plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 7, plus 1 by 7 minus, if I put 3, 3 3 is 9, 3 12, 1 13, like this, and so on, this will be finally 1 plus 1 minus n plus n square, and minus 1 plus n square, that will come finally, you know. So 1 to n, k is equal to 1 to n. If you see this, this cancel, that will also cancel, this will also cancel by the last one, and that will be also cancelled by the previous one. So in this way, what is left? N tends to infinity, 1 by 2, 1 is left from here, and this term is left from here, 1 plus n square. If you will simplify this, what will come? 1 by 2, n square, 1 plus n square plus n, 1 plus n square minus 1 divided by 1 plus n square, 1 1 cancel, and in that case it is left like 2 n square plus n divided by n square plus n 1. Remember this, we have discussed such a type of question, and automatically you will be able to say, because power of numerator and denominator are same, so highest power coefficient will give answer when limit n tends to infinity. So 1 will give here answer, 1 and 1 by 2, 1 into 1 by 2 is 1 by 2 answer. But just to for sake of convenience, I can write here n square 1 plus 1 by n, and again n square, that is 1 plus 1 by n plus 1 by n square. I can write this cancel, n tends to infinity, 1 by n tends to 0, then 1 by n tends to 0, and therefore what is left? That will left like 1 by 2 into 1 plus 0 upon 1 plus 0 plus 0, that is 1 by 2, and this is the answer of this question. So answer of this question is 1 by 2. Once you know that, how to deal with this question in very quick seconds, just try to understand this. Once you come to know about this factor, from this factor, one can write directly this one. And once you know that, then you will see what will be the first term left, first term and last term only left. So first term obtained from k is equal to 1, and last term obtained by putting n is equal to k is equal to n. So first and last term only left, all these story are endless, and thereafter you will see the what will be the coefficient of numerator and denominator. Obviously that will be n square coefficient 1 in numerator, and n square has coefficient 1 in denominator. So 1 will left, and 1 by 2 into 1, that is 1 by 2. So that can be answered strictly without doing all these things. right? Okay, so let me answer the question, some question, and some more question. Okay, so second question is, so third question is, let us try to solve third question. Limit x tends to infinity, x square minus x plus 1 minus x minus x plus b is equal to 0. This is what given, and also it is given that for k is greater than 2, limit n tends to infinity, say to the power 2n, k factorial pi b, then what will be the relation between a and b? That can be question. Then what will be the relation between a and b? One can write option like a is equal to b, a is equal to minus b, or c option can be a is equal to 2b, and d option can be 2a is equal to b, right? So this is all about going for this question, and that type of question might be difficult for you. So let me explain this. Here limit x tends to infinity, because this is in numerator only, so I can write it and rationalize it only. So whenever you will rationalize this, x square minus x plus 1 minus x plus b, and divided by x square minus x plus 1 minus x plus b, and in numerator also x square minus x plus 1, and this is plus negative, so plus x plus b. I can write this. So multiply by numerator and denominator, what will come? X tends to infinity, x square minus x plus 1 minus x plus b whole square, whole divided by x square minus x plus 1 plus x plus b. That can be possible. Now this can be further written as x tends to infinity, x square, coefficient of x square will come minus a from this side. So 1 minus a square into x square will come, and coefficient of 2x will be minus 1 from here and minus 2ab here. So if I would take minus common, then 1 minus 2ab into x plus 1 here and minus b square is there. So that will come. In denominator, it is coming like under root x. If I took x common from this, that will remain 1 my x minus x square I have taken common, so it will be 1 plus 1 by x minus 1 minus 1 by x plus 1 by x square. In this, if I have taken x square common, it will remain 1 minus 1 by x plus 1 by x square, plus what if I had taken x common here also, a plus b by x, and whole thing comes x common. Now obviously, it is given in the question that limiting value is 0. And remember, when limiting value is 0, what I had told you, that whenever limit x tends to infinity and denominator is greater than numerator, in that case, the value of the limit would be 0. So, degree of denominator must be greater than denominator. It means, if I would have taken x, this is degree of denominator, that is a linear factor, and linear equation must be greater than this. It means this is 2 must be equal to 0. In numerator, there should be only constant, no coefficient of x square or x. It means this is possible 0 if and only if 1 minus a square is equal to 0, that is a square is equal to 1, or a is equal to plus minus 1. Now here 1 plus 2ab should be also 0. 1 plus 2ab. So should be also 0, and for this 2ab is equal to minus 1. If I put a is equal to plus minus 1, then what will happen? b is equal to 1 minus 2a, that is minus 1 by plus minus 2. A is equal to plus minus 1, so b can have plus minus half only. Now, the second part of the question, let me discuss with the second part of the question. Second part of the question deals with limit n tends to infinity, sec a square to the power 2n, k factorial. This is half, b is either plus half or minus half, so they must be integral multiple of pi by 2, maybe plus or minus, right now? So they must be integral multiple of pi, because in k factorial, for k is greater than 2, definitely it will be divisible by 2. Even if you put 2, then 2 cancel, and what will be that? Pi. And say pi is plus minus 1, because say even multiple of pi it will be 1. If it is odd multiple of pi, then it will be minus 1. But both the cases, because of this square, it will be always positive. So here, value of this is always positive. This is described as b, and this will be always positive. So this is what? 1. 1 to the power 2 n is equal to 1. N tends to even infinity, but perfect 1 will have power infinity is equal to 1. If it is perfect 1, then power infinity would be 1. In that case, this value is 1. And what is a? A is plus minus a, and therefore a can have value. Answer will be not b. Here options can be given like a minus a or 2a or 3a, like that will be the answer. Right now? So this type can be option. So what is a? What is answer? This is 1. And 1 is what? A. A has value 1, so answer is A, and A will be answer of this question, that is first option. First option will be the answer of this question. Option can be given like this, right? This is just a generation of the questions which has generated before you, and definitely you will be able to get it. That kind of option can be created by question setter, and you will be able to solve it, right? So hopefully you learn these questions, how to deal with such questions. Right? Let us discuss one more question. And what is that? Try to understand. The question is, here the question is, a is equal to limit n tends to infinity, a is equal to 1 to n, 1 upon r plus 2 into r factorial, and b is equal to e to the power sin x minus e to the power x upon sin x minus x. Now, which of the following is true? That can be answered. Which of the following is true? Following is true. And what are the options? A is equal to b, a is equal to minus b, a is equal to 2b, and b, 2a is equal to b, like that. Maybe, like this, that can be option. So what to do and how to deal with this question? Let me explain this. A is equal to limit n tends to infinity, sigma n is equal to 1 to n. If I multiply by r plus 1 in numerator as well as in denominator, then that will be a consecutive product. So we can write this r plus 2 factorial. Right? So that can be written as sigma n is equal to 1 to n, r is equal to 1 to n, r is equal to 1 to n, r plus 2 minus 1 upon r plus 2 factorial. Can I write like this? Or in place of writing r plus 2 factorial, I can write all these things. Right? So r plus 2 into r plus 1 into r factorial. So what will happen? Limit n tends to infinity, R is equal to 1 to n R plus 2 divided by R plus 2 into R plus 1 into R factorial minus 1 upon R plus 2 in factorial, because that whole thing can be written as R plus 2 factorial. So what will be the limit tends to infinity? Sigma R is equal to 1 to n. This is 1 upon R plus 1 factorial minus 1 upon R plus 2 factorial. So that will come, right? So this will come and we can proceed like this. Here what will happen? That limit n tends to infinity sigma R is equal to 1 to n 1 by r plus 1 factorial minus 1 by r plus 2 factorial, the same thing I am writing here again. And just to conclude this, and now you can put the value of r is equal to 1 to 3. So what will happen? Limit n tends to infinity, if I put r is equal to 1, then this will be 1 by 2 factorial minus 1 by 3 factorial, plus if I put r is equal to 2, then that will be 1 by 3 factorial minus 1 by 4 factorial. And similarly, it will come like 1 upon n plus 1 factorial minus 1 upon n plus 2 factorial. So that will come. So that these are cancels, you know, that will be cancels. And now limit n tends to infinity. What is left? 1 by 2 factorial minus 1 upon n plus 2 factorial. When n tends to infinity, this will be infinity and 1 upon infinity would be 0. So what is left? 1 by 2 factorial, that is 1 by 2. So here value of a will be 1 by 2. Now let me see what is the value of b, and for this I need to rub this board. So I hope you got it. What I did here, r plus 1 multiply divide, then plus 2 minus 1, so that 1 can be cancelled, and now it will be 1 by r plus 1 factorial. So let me do the next part of this. What is the value of b? So b is equal to given, limit x tends to 0, sorry, in writing question something you might escape from the mind, x tends to 0, so that it will be in form of 0 by 0, e to the power of sin x minus 1 minus e to the power x plus 1. I did plus 1 minus 1 divided by sin x minus x, limit x tends to 0. Why I did so? Because we know the formula e to the power x minus 1 upon x is equal to 1 when x tends to 0. So just to apply this, I can write it like limit x tends to 0 e to the power sin x minus 1, if whole divided by sin x and multiply by sin x, it can be 1. I have divided by sin x so that it will be 1 and multiply by sin x. Here if I took negative sign common, that will be e to the power x minus 1. This can be also divided by x, multiply by x, and in denominator it is sin x minus x. As per formula, these two value will be 1 and 1. So what is left? X tends to 0, 1 into sin x minus 1 into x divided by sin x minus x. It is the same thing, 1 into sin x is sin x, 1 into x is x, both can be cancelled, and what is left? 1. So b is 1 and a is equal to half. So what you can say, a is equal to half and b is equal to 1, what will be the lesson? Twice of a is equal to b. Twice of a is equal to b, that will be the answer of this question. So twice of a is equal to b is given in d option, and that will be the answer of this question. So hopefully you got it. This type of question can be solved like this, and you will be able to solve it quickly. So it will be better. Just watch, think this video, and continuously we have some more lectures in limit and continuity. Share and subscribe our channel and be prepared for next IIT. Thank you very much. All the best.